Brackets on its own is a great code editor, but like other popular editors on the market today, it becomes even better with extensions. In this lesson, I'm going to talk about the Extension Manager and share a few of my favorite extensions. You can get to the extensions by clicking on this button right here. I talked quickly about the Extension Manager when I discussed themes in the Workspace lesson. One thing that's changed since I recorded that is that themes are in their own tab now. When you want to look at the themes, you can click on this tab to search. The Available tab is showing me all the extensions that are published and registered through the Brackets registry. It's very simple to use the Extension Manager. You just search right here, then install by clicking on this button when you find what you want. It's also possible to install extensions by dragging a downloaded version here or by typing in the URL. I'm going to look for trailing so I can find the extension to strip trailing white spaces. There are a few options, but this one at the bottom is the one I've used before. Before you install an extension, it's a good idea to click on the links to the author and more info so you can verify that it's what you want and that you can trust the extension on your Brackets installation. I like to make sure that the extension has been around a while before I install it. I also like to look at issues and see if there are any problems. You can see if the author is responsive by looking at the closed issues as well. So this one hasn't been updated since last year, which isn't necessarily a problem for something small, but when I look at the issues, it says that it's using some deprecated code and may not work with the next release. I'll install this Whitespace Normalizer instead. Click on the Install button, then close the message and the manager. Now if I add some whitespace to my index.html file and save it, I can see the whitespace is removed. I can turn it off if I want to keep white space in some files. The option is under the Edit menu. Another extension that I really like is Brackets Icons. It adds a little visual help when you're looking at the files in the sidebar. There are two versions in the Extension Manager. I believe the second one is a fork of the first with different icons. I'll install this first one. You can see that each file type has its own icon. I find this helpful when I have a lot of files open in the working file set. Plus, one of the reasons I like Brackets is its visual appeal, and this adds to it for me. One problem I have with Brackets is when you copy and paste code and you don't have your cursor at the beginning of the line. If I go to Mac.html and try to copy some of the list items from one place to another, if I paste them in here, the first line is not lined up correctly. The workaround is to get your cursor to the beginning of the line and then paste, but there's a nice extension to help with this called Paste and Indent. It isn't working yet. Normally extensions work right away, but on occasion I find I have to refresh to make it work. When it's installed, I can paste in code and it will go into the correct spot regardless of where my cursor is. It works well in other scenarios also where you might have different indent levels, so I find this extension really helpful. I've gone ahead and installed some of the other extensions I use in my workflow already. We can see those under the Installed tab. Beautify lets me fix the formatting of code. I talked about display shortcuts in the key mapping lesson. Join Lines just gives you a shortcut to join two lines. Markdown Preview is self-explanatory, and QuickDocsJS gives us the same QuickDoc functionality for JavaScript that we already have with CSS. I'll demonstrate all of these now. If I open the plugins.js file, you can see it has four spaces since it came from the HTML5 boilerplate. I can run Beautify on it through the Edit menu or with the shortcut. Notice this last line is an option to beautify on save. I keep that off personally because I work with underscore templates in my job and I found it can mess those up. I prefer to run it on an as-needed basis with the menu. I actually never remember this shortcut. You can see that it took my preference of two spaces and made this file conform to that. It is using this preference when it runs. Also under the Edit menu are the shortcuts for join lines. These shortcuts will be the same on both platforms. I can join two lines with a space in between or with no space. These shortcuts are pretty handy when you're editing code. When you're looking at a Markdown file, the Markdown Preview icon will show up in the right icon panel. As you're typing the text in Markdown format, you can see how it's translated into HTML in the preview. There are a few options that you can change in the settings for how it displays. You can toggle the preview off with the button. Let's try QuickDocsJS. If I go to main.js and try command.k, I get the inline documentation for function. I often click on the Read More link if I really want to understand what's going on. It takes you to the Mozilla reference pages, which are very good. One really great thing is that it will also use the jQuery API for jQuery functions, and it will take you to that documentation as well. By the way, there is a QuickDocs extension for PHP and also for regular expressions. I should mention that extensions get updated at times, and if you notice the Extension Manager button is green, that means you need to update some of your extensions. If you go to the Installed tab, you'll see green buttons on those that need to be updated. This is not a complete list of all the extensions that I use, but it includes many I think will be useful to most people. I'm going to be covering some of the more complex extensions in the future through Learnable's Developer Toolbox series. I'll also be reviewing some extensions on my blog, cssnippets.com. So we're almost done with the course. I still have one more topic I want to cover, and that's troubleshooting problems with brackets. I'll do that in the next lesson.